always loved me.
Bakhtawar was born in January 1990. 7 months later, on August 6th, the president undemocratically dismissed my government while world attention was diverted by Iraq's occupation of Kuwait. My husband was arrested, and my mother suggested I send my children abroad. It was heartrending for me to be parted from Bilawal, who had just turned two in September 1990, and Bakhtawar, who was not yet one. My sister, who lived in London, lovingly took them into her home. My in-laws chipped in too by shifting to London. Back at home, I had nightmares where I heard my children cry for me. My sister would tell me not to worry during our many telephonic conversations, yet those dreams never stopped. With the sacking of my government, the port city of Karachi was gripped by anarchy and chaos. Terrorism was rampant. Innocent civilians were massacred while riding in public transport or outside their homes or in their offices. I knew it was safer for my children to be in London, yet I found it hard to sleep at night after night, only to wake with those nightmares. My mother and I were now living largely in the capital city of Islamabad. My husband, elected to parliament in the 1990 elections, was also kept under house arrest in our residence during parliamentary sessions. I confided to my mother and husband how draining it was for me that my children were living away from me. I felt I was abandoning them and worried that it could hurt their emotional well-being and growth. By 1991, Bilawal had started attending a pre-kindergarten school in London's Queen's Gate area. Bakhtawar was still only 1 year old. I could keep her hidden safely in our house in Pakistan, I reasoned. I flew to London and could hardly wait to get to my sister Sanam's flat. As soon as I knocked on her door, I heard my daughter crying, the same cry that had sounded in my dreams. I quickly gathered her in my arms and pulled my son towards me. I have decided to take Bakhtawar back with me, I told my sister. She was relieved. I didn't want to upset you, she said, but that child has not stopped crying for months. Without words being spoken, it seemed that both the children knew what was to come. I shall never forget, as long as I live, the sight of Bilawal sitting in his white shirt, blue striped trousers, white socks, and black shoes on the floor of the corridor with his back against the wall. He was staring at me. Silently and stoically, with the saddest brown eyes in the world, as I took Bakhtawar along with me and left him behind. No mother should ever have to leave her two-year-old son behind. No child should feel his mother has taken one child with her and left the other behind. Holding Bakhtawar in my arms, I drove to Heathrow. She lay quietly in my embrace. I boarded the Pakistan International flight and sat in my seat. Throughout the nine-hour flight, Bakhtawar did not cry once. She nestled her face on my shoulder and slept. Pakistan's legendary music artist, Madam Noor Jahan, was also on the flight. Sitting next to me, she marveled at this wonderful baby who was not giving her mother any trouble at all. I've never seen a baby this quiet on a flight in my life, she said.
So